Hello again, everybody. It's Harry Boxer, the Technical Trader. It's Wednesday, April 21st. These are the charts of the day. Today, alphabetically, once again, we're going to look at some longs. AERG, Applied Energetics, is having a good time of late. As you can see, the long base that formed over the last year was broken with a thrust in late March. Not as much volume as I'd like to see, but it did build to a head at the peak here and then backed off, consolidated in a little wedge, and then broke out this week, yesterday, and today, with a nice follow-through today. Still a low-priced stock. Let's take a look at the longer-term pattern and get an idea of where resistance may be. Right now, we're looking at a level up in here at which we'll probably be approaching shortly around the 180 range. That's my short-term target. Secondary target would be up at this zone around the let's take a quick closer look on that. That's about 290. So that would be my trading target on it, something around 290 over the course of the next few days to weeks or so. AKRX had another good day today. Notice the thrust in the last four sessions, up one day, two-day consolidation at resistance, broke through, got through that secondary resistance level, maybe headed now towards a test of $3 in my short-term trading target. Certainly a breakout of the entire pattern. Beyond that, that level is actually closer to 285, 290. Beyond that, if it should continue, I have a secondary target around 4 and then a longer-term target around 5.5, maybe doable, AKRX. CPWM, cost plus, which we've mentioned several times in our charts of the day, after breaking out, thrusting up towards resistance, it backed off, formed a wedge, broke out on heavy volume, and it's been really thrusting nicely and moving up in a rising flag type formation with great technicals. I'd expect this one may have more to go on the upside, although there's a possibility it may retest first. But my short-term trading target is 6, longer-term trading target around 9. CTT, Competitive Technologies, broke out across key resistance today, jumping 31% or 71 cents on 827,000, one of the heaviest volume days we've seen. A key breakout from a 5 or 6 day pennant occurred today, and a nice thrust. Let's take a look at where targets may be. I'd have to say around 365, there's some resistance, but trading target around 4.75, 5 short term. Delcath, DCTH, a stock we've liked a lot this year. As you can see why, the trend has been beautiful all for about a year now. Trading range consolidation basing pattern was broken. Stock thrust at the end of March, and then it moved into a more subdued but sharply rising channel. Tonight after the close, the company came out with a very positive phase 3 drug results, and is now trading near 14 from 1085. Should be a big day for that one tomorrow. By being inclined to take some off the table tomorrow in the 1415 range, look for a pullback and then maybe wait for a secondary thrust. ELON, ELON, had a significant day, breaking a six-month declining tops line and taking out lateral price resistance as well with its 91-cent thrust, up about 10% on 750,000 shares. That's the heaviest volume since the February bottom and could be signaling a change of characteristics that thrust this stock back up. Now, we have some minor resistance around 10.75, and my short-term trading target, secondary target around 12. 12.5, excuse me. ENTG had a nice move last week and has been consolidating very nicely in a little bullish wedge here on low volume. I'm pointing this out because I think it's a nice setup for a move and a breakout that takes this one up towards the 6.5-7 zone. And then a longer term target, let's call the target at 8, shorter term, and once we get through that, we have a target in 11-12 zone. Network Engines, NENG, also been in a beautiful rising channel. This low price stock is starting to accelerate with volume. Is that key overhead resistance in the zone? Backed off a little bit today, although it did peek its head through it. And right now, with this accelerated pattern and trend and with volume building, we could see a spike up that takes this one up towards the $4 range rather quickly. There is a key resistance zone right in this area going back multi-years. So if we get any follow through here, the stock could run. Secondary target at 5 and longer term target at 8. Pacific Capital Bank Corp was one of the banks that has really come back sharply in the last few days. But more importantly, after reaching a bottom in November, the stock based out, finally came through resistance in mid-March, formed a little bit of a wedge on low volume right here, and then accelerated, mini flagged, and yesterday and today are spiking up on volume. Now, maybe short-term overbought, but the key being that that secondary resistance was taken out today with a thrust, and that move up towards the 5 3/4 range may be in store, and that's our initial target, secondary target up around the 7 range. Pharmacolytics, which we've mentioned many times in this report, and here's why. You can see the beautiful rising channel that's occurred on this one. Right now, a beautiful bull flag is forming with low volume and great technicals. I expect this trend to continue. Short-term target around 9.5, 10. Longer-term target around 12 or so. Intermediate target at 12. See, Quality Distribution, the trucking firm, has been motoring. Excuse the pun. We had a nice move up here in a consolidation, another nice leg up in a consolidation. And today, the stock popped 35 cents, or almost 4.7%. Volume increase, so did technicals. It looks like the short-term sharply rising channel, which is in force, may move this towards the top of the channel, up around the 9.5 area, my short-term trading target. Quick Logic had a big day today, accelerating for a 31, about almost 10%, 33 cents. And as you can see, the bottom in November triggered a strong move up, and has seen the stock move from 120 up to 385, more than tripling. The key is, though, that the last couple of days we've taken out the October highs, and now we may be moving towards the top of the long-term channel, which comes in around the 5.5 range, my secondary target. TGA, Transglobe, one of the few oil, junior oils that is not giving it up here. As a matter of fact, it's pushing forward and a beautiful rising channel. However, it is at some key lateral resistance. If it pops through here, I can see this stock looking at 8.25, 8.5 short term. And that's it for some of the ideas for today. The market refuses to give it up despite the recent pullback. Nice consolidation day today, but we'll see what happens going forward. I'm still of the opinion that we're near an important potential peak, and that any longs that I talk about here should be played with sensible stops. Good evening. Have a good one.